Before we get into all that, here's Principal Duvall, the week ahead, and Bill Tilden with the sports rundown.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the rundown. Today is Sunday, March 28th. It's the last week in March. We're going to start with a Sunday night event. We have been hosting AP Zooms. Our current ambassadors are hosting informational sessions on AP courses for students that are interested in taking them next year. So tonight, starting at 6 o'clock, our ambassadors will be presenting the AP Science courses for interested students. Tomorrow's March 29th, it's a Monday, full remote Monday. We've got a girls' soccer game at home at 3:45 versus Case. Tuesday, March 30th, day one in our cycle with Cohort A in the building, Cohort B at home. Volleyball is at home at 6 p.m. against Case. Wednesday, March 31st, another day one. This time we'll flip the cohorts. Cohort B will be here. Cohort A will be learning from home. In the afternoon, volleyball is hosting Brockton at 5:45 in the gym. Thursday's April 1st, April Fool's Day. It's going to be our day two in our calendar. For day two, Cohort A is in the building. Cohort B learns from home. Boys varsity soccer at home versus Somerset in the afternoon, 3:45. Friday, April 2nd, day two, Cohort B in the building. Cohort A at home. Two school events after school, field hockey at 3:30. Football at 4 o'clock at Greater New Bedford Voc. If you haven't heard, we are coming back full-time in person. The date's going to be April 27th, so that's exciting for the school community. We'll have all of our students back in the building Tuesday, April 27th. Until then, the month of April awaits. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you very much, Mr. Duvall. And fall two sports have begun. Girls volleyball, two matches already. They're the only sport that's had any matches or games yet. They beat Somerset Berkeley on Tuesday, 3-0, and then they hosted our first home game with Durfee yesterday and won 3-1. So congratulations to girls volleyball. Soccer takes the pitch today. Boys soccer is at home today. Girls soccer is up at Seekonk. Field hockey is on Friday. And then we have track and football going on Saturday. So football is over at New Bedford Voc, 4 p.m. varsity game. You'll be able to catch that right on ORC TV on their Facebook page. So we're really looking forward to that. Fan guidance is for our soccer games and field hockey games. We will have fans be able to come and watch, also with the track. We are allowing two away fans for each of their players to also come and see their student athletes, many of them seniors this year. So we want to give them the opportunity to watch them play. The football is limited to, because of what could be the possible crowd sizes, they are limited to four visitors per athlete, two on the visiting side. Good luck to everybody. We will have a whole lot of results for next week because every team will have multiple games in the next week. Looking forward to talk about it more then and see you all soon. Don't forget to miss the football game on Saturday. Thank you.
Ogres. Let's get into it. Fighting an ogre is knowing what ogre you're fighting. We have a couple different types of ogres. First, how do you describe an ogre? Boom. Head. Easy. Big ears. Easier. Big nose. This is so easy. Angry. Wow. Big, rotten teeth. Boom. That's an ogre right there. Maybe they have clothes, like a shirt. We're stopping there. Now, if this is an ogre, and let's move on to the first ogre that people think of. Our man. Shrek. Look at this guy, eh? Big, rotund, fits all of our descriptions. But you know what Shrek says? He says that he's an onion. That's an onion. This doesn't make any sense. This guy's lying to us. Now, third type of ogre. Boom, big, form. Eyes that are weird. Kind of normal nose. Sharp teeth, right? These guys don't have big ears. These are Oni, also known as Japanese or magic ogres. These guys, guess who's in there? Guess who's in that little place? Your kid. And look, they're sad. That guy eats kids. How could an onion eat kids, huh? Ogres are deceptive, evil, cruel beings. What's next? How do you fight an ogre? An ogre? Think of this as your little ogre buddy with his big club. They're like, kind of like giants, you know? Good giant, also with a bigger club. Usually have beards, you know? If these guys are a little bit less than these guys, then how do you fight a giant? And how do you fight a giant? You got you? How did Jack and the Beanstalk do it? Guess what he did? Ran over like a puddle or something? Yeah, sure, that's how it went. And look, giant. Whoops. Slipped and fell, cracked his head open, blood everywhere. Dead giant. So, that being said, although we know that ogres are big, scary, and deceptive, they're also stupid. They're dumb. What are they going? Hate these guys. So, this is the ogre. Boom. Big arms. This guy's running towards you. You are here. Little tiny baby boy, huh? Little tiny baby boy standing on a hill. Boom. Ogre's coming at you. What you gonna do? You're gonna run. You're gonna run until you find a puddle. And then when the ogre gets close to the puddle, he'll fall over. Now, ogres, thick skulls. Stupid. Remember this. Stupid. Thick skulls. They don't die easily. So, once they're on the ground, you get up on their chest. This is you. And you say, you're just onions. Ogres think that they're onions. We know this because of Shrek. So when you say you're just onions, boom, guess what they now are? Onions, just that easy. This is how you defend yourself from ogres. Remember the phrase, you're just onions. You're just onions.
Whoa, you barely got out of that one, Chris.
Thank you for risking your life for our safety.
Next up, we are headed down to the beauty salon to transform a Barbie that's not into a Barbie that's hot with Rachel. Let's take a look.
Hi everyone, it's Rachel, and I'm back with another video for this week's episode of Bulldog Weekly. I'm running a little low on ideas for what to do for this show. So, today we're gonna do a Barbie doll makeover. This is Bernice. I think she's from Target, probably. I don't know, my mom bought it for me. Today, Bernice here is gonna be getting a little hair dye job, maybe some tattoos, and a whole new outfit. That's gonna be exciting. I've never really done any of this before, so we're gonna play it by ear and see what happens. I think we'll start with the hair. I think that's probably our best bet. We're gonna do that first. I'm gonna get some water real quick. I'll be right back. Okay, I got the water. I don't think I need that much. Again, maybe I won't even need it at all. We're playing this by ear. I got some food dye for the hair. It was all we had. And yeah, I got a couple different colors, but we're gonna see which one's best. I gotta open this box first. That's what we gotta do first. Here she is, out of the box, ready for her hair appointment. I like the length she has, so I am gonna cut it, but I don't wanna cut it that short, you know what I mean? Probably cut it like to her shoulders, maybe? I think I'm gonna wet it first so that it's easier to cut. Oh, what has this show become? It's pretty damp. Hair's wet. Now we're gonna cut it. I didn't bring like a hair elastic to like tie it back or anything. We're gonna take off like a little bit first because, you know, we can cut more off, but we can never put it back, so. Okay. That's weird. That was a pretty clean cut considering I've never done this before. I'd like to cut bangs, but should we try it? Ooh, I think I should try it. Something in my bones is telling me I should cut bangs. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. It didn't really work. She's kinda just got like a weird, like it's shorter in the front now, that part. It's not bad, it still works. She makes it work. I do think we should go a little bit shorter. Maybe not. It's uneven though. I made it worse. So I think this is good. I think this is the cut we're going for right here. She's got like kind of a bang situation going on in the front. I actually didn't do a terrible job with that. See? Now we're gonna dye it. I'm gonna try my best to not get food coloring all over my clothes because this sweatshirt is not mine. My sister's gonna shank me if she watches this video and sees me dyeing Barbie doll hair in her sweatshirt. So I think we're gonna go for some blues today. These two shades of blue are different. I think I'm gonna use them both. I brought a paintbrush so I could kind of like paint the dye on and make it, you know. Oh! Okay. Can't really see yet. I'm gonna put some more on, but I think I'm doing a pretty good job. Not to flex or anything. Oh, this is not how you dye hair. You're supposed to like take it one piece at a time, right? Oh well. My boss was telling me like that she's seen people make videos like this before. And she was like, oh, and the Barbie dolls usually come out looking pretty cool. I don't think my video is going to have the same kind of results, but we're going to chill with the hair dye for a little bit. I think this is as good as it's going to get. You probably can't really see it that well. I'll try and hold it closer. It's got some nice, it's not really like a full dye job, but it's like she's got some nice tints of blue and purple on top there. The underneath of her hair is still this color. Here's the twist. This is also a tattoo parlor. So Bernice is gonna get tatted up right about now. I think we should give her like a mom tattoo. Put that on her arm. Oh, this marker kind of sucks. Probably do like just some fun little designs. Maybe a flower tattoo. She seems like she would have one of those. I don't think they have any Barbie dolls with tattoo sleeves, but they should make some. So we've made some interesting decisions with her tattoo design. She didn't tell me what she wanted, so I just assumed that I could do whatever I want. I mean, these tattoos aren't great, but she's gonna have to schedule another appointment if she wants them to look better. I think I wanna tie her hair back. You can't really tell if the hair is different, so I wanna at least try and show in some way that we changed it up a little bit. She's got a little messy ponytail going on, and you can see the hack job I did with her hair really well in this ponytail. Oh no, she got hair dye on her face. She's a mess. This is also a fashion studio, along with a hair salon and a tattoo parlor. We're gonna make Bernice some clothes, because I love the bathing suit, but it's not summer yet. I found this fabric at my house. It's definitely part of a sleeve that I cut off a shirt. I don't know why I kept it, but now we're gonna put it to use. And I also have some duct tape. I can tape it down. Ooh, I like that. Okay. All right, now we're gonna get some duct tape to add a little extra flair to the dress. Look at this little skirt she's got going on in the back. It was mainly just my mistake, but it kind of works. I'm just gonna add a few finishing touches for the makeup, and then honestly, I think we're good. So, let's talk about it. This is new and improved. I wouldn't say improved, but the new Bernice. You know, she's got some blue, purple, green tints in her hair. It's a little bit hard to see, but they're there, trust me. She's got some dark makeup going on, because, you know, there are a lot of, like, punk emo Barbies. So, she can be the first one. This went better than I expected it to go. What I did learn from this is I shouldn't go into cosmetology. That is all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Maybe you should try this at home. This actually might be a fun little craft. I know I enjoyed it. So I'm gonna clean up this hair. Or maybe I'll just leave it and freak everyone out. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Hello everybody, welcome back to another one of my cooking segments. This week I'm going to be making some meatballs. So I've already prepped a couple of the ingredients ahead of time, and these include, I took a large pan, filled the brim, filled a decent amount of it with water, and after that I put 2 chicken bouillon cubes in to give it a little bit more flavor when we cook the meatballs in there. I have also crushed some garlic that I'm going to be using later. That's something else I have prepared. But first things first is that for the meatballs, we are going to use 1 pound or 16 ounces of ground chicken. So I've already washed my hands. So before we start this, or while we start this, I'm going to go ahead and take some scissors and open the package, open this up, and pour all of it right into this bowl, where we are going to be mixing the meatballs. After that, we're just gonna take this and put it aside. And after this, we're gonna take some green onions. Now, we don't need all of these green onions, so we're just gonna take like 3 or so. And, it's a bit tricky. So, actually, I'll go left-handed. So I'm gonna take them and then cut them into tiny little pieces. All right, after we put the green onions in, next thing we are going to put in is some of the crushed garlic. Now for this, ginger. So for this, I just took some freeze-dried ginger, put it on a plate, and crush it up. So now it's all nice little crushed garlic. And I'm gonna take this and I'm just gonna dump that right in with the rest of it. After I do that, we have one more ingredient to put in, which we're gonna take two egg yolks, and we're gonna put those in there. Now you don't need, if you want, you have two different options for the eggs. You can either separate the eggs and the yolks and then put the egg and then put the yolks in there, or you can just put one whole egg in there. Doesn't matter too much, but I'm just gonna go ahead and separate the yolk from the egg while I do this. So I'm just gonna go ahead and open that. And then I'm just gonna be careful. There we go, we have two parts of the egg. Now we're just gonna put the yolk there and back. I've done this before. So, just moving the yolk from one half of the shell to the other while the egg white just drips into the bowl. After we do that, we only have the yolk. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take the yolk and put that in there. And then if a little bit of egg white gets in there too, that's okay. We're gonna do that again. Just go back and forth, nice and quick. Get the egg white out of there while keeping the yolk intact. Oh, and there we go. After that, you have all of the ingredients. Probably. After you put the ingredients in, you're just going to, it might be a little bit messy, but you're just gonna take your hands and you're gonna go in there and you're gonna mix everything up. Okay, now that we have very well mixed all the meatballs and the garlic and everything else together, and the ginger, sorry, not garlic, it keeps on popping up in my head. After we get all in there, we're gonna put some meatballs in the pan. So to do this, there's a couple of different ways to do it. The way I like to do it is I just like to put them in. So I like to take a meatball, and then roll it a little bit. Make sure they're not too big. Take a meatball, roll it, so it's a nice circle shape. And then you're just gonna throw it in. There we go. And we're going to keep on repeating this. Just take another meatball, roll it up, throw it in. Just like that, nice and simple. Oh, wow. Take a meatball, roll it up, put it in. Don't worry, just try not to touch your face after you're touching raw meat, because that probably isn't very healthy. So when you're handling with raw meat, you want to be handle it with extreme care and wash your hands before and after. I washed my hands right before I recorded this, and right after I finished this, I'm also gonna wash my hands. So just a quick little disclaimer to help you guys. Oh, I forgot one thing. After you put all the meatballs into the pan, set a timer for 5 minutes to wait for them to cook. After that 5 minutes, you wanna wait a little bit to make sure they're done. If you wanna be safe, you can take one, you can cut it up into a little cup, a few little bits, and then see if the inside is cooked all the way or not, because it's important to make sure they're cooked all the way. And after you're done, you can go ahead and just take it off the main burner. Be careful, don't eat these right now, because they're extremely hot right now. But, as you can see, our beautiful chicken meatballs are done. Bon appetit.
First name is James. I'm not here to judge you. I just want to ask you a few questions. Do you know where you are, James? I can't help you if you don't talk to me, James. Bucky.
Bucky. Where the hell is Bucky?
Hey guys, so today I'm going to be analyzing slash giving the history of Falcon and the Winter Soldier for the new show, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Right now we're going to start with the Winter Soldier, aka Bucky Barnes, aka James Buchanan Barnes, my man Sebastian Stan. He first starts off in Captain America, the first Avenger, where he's like best friends with Cap. It's all great. I don't have the footage from that, but I have all these. So he is kidnapped from Hydra, injected with a serum that's similar to Steve's, Captain America's serum, but not exactly the same. And then he's brainwashed and put into, he's just frozen for a while. And they like erase his mind a bunch, and they do a bunch of stuff to like make him controllable. They have like code words and stuff that makes him go crazy. They give him assignments to go off and kill certain people. And Winter Soldier, and in Falcon and the Winter Soldier, there is a lot of stuff that he deals with from that trauma that he killed a bunch of people.
So, Mr. Barnes, are you still having nightmares?
And you see some of that, and I'll show you a clip now.
James, I asked you a question. Are you still having nightmares?
No.
We've been doing this long enough that I can tell when you're lying. Well, you seem a little off today. Did something happen recently?
What a great clip. That was such a great clip. Good job. One of the people that he kills is Tony Stark's parents in a car crash, and that's in Civil War. And there's a lot of stuff there, and the majority of Civil War is not just about the Sokovia Accords, but also about how Tony feels betrayed by Steve, who's Bucky's best friend. And then, okay, so in Civil War, they put him on ice again until they figure out how to fix his mind. Not change his mind, just fix it so he doesn't have, so he's not as controllable like he was with Hydra. So he's in Wakanda. They give him a new arm and he fights, and it's so cool. I want to show the clip of him with Rocket. It's great.
How much for the gun?
Not for sale.
Okay, how much for the arm?
Oh, I'll get that arm.
Then he disappears in the blip. And then the next time we see him is an Endgame when he fights. But then after that, it's the new TV show episode, and it looks great. And I'm pretty excited.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing my brother, the Falcon. Okay. He does not get enough credit. He's a really cool character. He's like, I don't even remember how he meets him. But
he meets him in the on your left scene.
Right, right,
like
right. He's
around.
Yeah, he's just running.
So they meet like there, and then he's like on your left, and it's so cute. In Endgame, it's Steve alone, and then they do a little.
He gives him the shield.
No, and then it's like on your left when they start battling.
Shut up. That's
after
right.
The blip. That's
oh my
the
God.
First line from anyone.
Shut up. That's
that.
So cute.
They have a great little relationship. So, Sam Wilson, we find out more about his history in the new show.
You do.
And he has a sister.
Get out.
Yeah, I forgot her name. But he has a sister. I'll put the name in. No. Okay. And he has a sister, and he has, like, two little nephews, and they, like, try to save the family boat, and it's all, like, hometowny, and it's all cute. And then,
I love that.
Yeah. So his history there is, like, he went into Afghanistan, Iraq, something like that. I'll put it in now. And they do a little history. He runs a VA, like he runs like a little like, group for past soldiers.
Gotcha.
And his best friend Riley died on the Falcon suit too. He like got shot down, which is in Winter Soldier, the movie. And it's all very sad.
It's very sad.
And then, like, Steve becomes a brother, and then Steve gives the shield to him. And then, oh my gosh, there's so much drama that happens in the new episode with the shield. Because it's, like, racially.
What?
Like, it's, like, about race.
Well, it was made in Wakanda.
No, not the shield. Like, because Fam doesn't feel like he deserves that shield. Oh. So he's like, I'll give it away. But then I'm gonna spoil it. But then at the end, it's a white guy who takes the shield. Just some random white guy. Because they're like, the new Captain America, the new symbol of hope. And it's
like, I don't know who that guy is. I keep seeing memes of him.
Yeah, it's like, what?
I was like, that is not literally, my, hashtag not my captain. Like, oh my god, like not my Roderick.
Dude. Oh my gosh. No, I mean, Diary of a Kid stuff in here? Oh my gosh. I don't think I have anything else to say. It's all very good.
Like it's someone else's.
Please go watch it. And I'm excited for the new episode that's coming out every Friday. There's 6 episodes and they're 50 minutes long. Bye.
School events, and so much more.